Hey guys, my name is Christopher and I'm from Dynaudio. Today we are in Munich for the annual high-end show. And with me here in the studio I have Geo. And Geo, can you just say a couple of words about yourself?
Yeah, I'm a mechanical designer here at Dynaudio. And I try to basically facilitate the work between the acoustic team and the designer.
And make something that...
And make something that can actually be produced and sound great. But it's not me that makes it sound great, it's those guys. Yeah,
perfect. Should we do a question?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, Geo, we have a question from Robert, and he asks what kind of analysis tools that we use.
Yeah, we use several different kind of tools. For example, if we use, if we want to make a simple strength calculation of, for example, the feet for the new contour line, we have a simulation tool that can be used for rather simple linear calculations, so that when you take the, let's take Contour 60 as an example, which is a speaker that weighs about 50-55
kilograms. So it's a heavy speaker.
It's a damn heavy speaker, yeah. And you tend to, when you move it around in your living room, you tend to let it rest on one leg and then slightly moving it. So the feet has to cope with the entire 50-55 kilos.
Yeah.
And that calculation tool makes it possible for us to do some simple preliminary calculations of whether or not the casted feet, in this case it's casted aluminum, can cope with the load.
Yeah.
So, or if it cannot cope with the load, then we try to use the tool to find out where we can improve the structure.
Mm.
For example, we make the roundings bigger to cope with
the force of the weight.
the von Mises stresses in that area.
So when you run a simulation like this, what does it look like? Because I haven't seen one, so I'm curious to know what it would.
Well, we get a pinpointed chart afterwards where it's color coded.
Okay.
So that the high stress areas are normally indicated by a color red, and the non-stressed or non-influenced areas are colored blue.
And from that. Those pinpoints, you can then say, okay, this is a weak area of the speaker.
Exactly.
And then you can go in and try to improve.
Yeah, you can. You can change the roundings. You can make it thicker. You can do different kind of adaptions so that you can cope with the stresses in the given area.
Yeah. And does it also apply to, you were talking about the feet now, but does it also apply to, for instance, the wall force or the cabinet itself? Would you go in and analyze on that?
Yeah, you can do that as well.
Yeah.
We have a different tool called COMSOL, which is a multi-physics tool.
Okay.
Where you can analyze in different aspects of the speakers. Also the airflow through the speaker and try to do some calculations of the needed bassboard sizes and stuff like that.
But it's all to find, I guess, to find weak areas and then try to improve on that?
Yeah. It is. And it's to make it a better sounding product first out of tool instead of, for example, sixth version, where we try different things. And this way we can get a better first prototype.
Yeah. And I guess that, I know that you as a mechanical engineer, you of course work closely with the acousticians and the product management team, and they come with a lot of ideas and wishes. And then you have to kind of make it work in real life, right?
Yeah.
And find a compromise that fits.
It's not always easy, though.
No, and I guess that a tool like this makes that. You talked about you avoid having to go through six different prototypes. It helps us start closer to the finish line, I guess.
Yeah, it does. Of course, we always need to make prototypes and test it in the given situations, but because there might have been something you didn't take into account. And when you're doing this kind of calculations, what you put in is what you get out.
Yeah.
So if what you put in is rubbish or it's not done thoroughly, then what you get out is useless.
So I guess the bottom line is that we actually do a lot of analyses, simulations, and calculations to find out if the speaker is structurally, I don't know if that's the right word, sound, and can hold up.
Yeah, we do.
And it was FEA? Finite?
FEA, you can call them finite element analysis.
Okay, and then COMSOL?
COMSOL is the same, but it works with multi-physics, so it takes more into consideration.
Yeah.
Whereas the other one we use for the simple linear is a basic strength tool.
Okay. So it all depends on how, on where in the process you are, which tool you would use.
Yeah.
Okay.
Exactly.
Perfect.